In a previous video, we used this gem to kind of get going with service workers, but it created some code which was kind of gnarly and was a bit 2015 in its approach. Nowadays, people will use a library like Workbox to kind of get going. And the reason I like kind of fell in love with this one is these two samples here. So if you want to cache the images, you just kind of write this code here and it's a lot more readable. Same with CSS and JS. It's more approachable than what we had before. So let's get going at adding that. So I've kind of gone ahead and reset my environment back to where it was before. And we're going to start by using this Webpack PWA yarn package, or NPM package even. And what this is going to do is it's going to let us output files without the little like hashes on it. So if I was to load that up, that's still fine. We'll have a look at that in a second, but the little like cache breakers at the end of files, because we need to always have our service worker having the same URL. So we're going to start by just adding it in. Awesome. And now we have to tell our Webpack environment about this new setup. So if I do Webpack environment, you can see it here. And it's requesting config as well, which we can get from this. So that would work just pretty well. And it also wants us to tell Rails about the service worker folder. So we haven't set one up yet, but I'm going to show you what that is. So the first thing we're going to do is go to config on Webpack. So config Webpack YAML, and we're just going to drop it in here. And what this is referring to is your path within app/JavaScript where your actual service workers are going to live. Like, so the thing we're going to be sending to the user. So what we want to do here is just create a folder called /service workers, and that'll work fine. And we could probably add like a little file called, let's call it client.js. Client.js, that'll be work, that'll be fine. And we're just going to do console.log, hey, I am in the service worker. Cool. So getting pretty close there. And we're also gonna add a companion as well. And for that, I'm just gonna put it in here somewhere. We're gonna just add that code we need to add to register these service workers. So I've kind of got it like hotkeyed on the side of my keyboard. I'm just gonna dump it in here for now because why not? Cool, and that's looking pretty good. So let's quickly turn on our Rails server. Okie dokie, that's ready to go now. So if we refresh the page, so we've got one service worker. So we can see it's requesting the client.js file like we wanted, but if I was to click that, it'll return a 404. So what's actually happened here? Is what Webpack has done is added a load of noise to the end of it. So we're going to rename that file from client because I think it's a protected phrase, or you know, it has something fancy going on. But we're just going to call it service worker. And cool, back in there. We're going to quickly restart our app so Webpacker picks up on it. Awesome. So we can see now this time it's outputted that file without the content hash. So if we were to quickly update our pack file just to say service worker, that should work pretty nicely. So let's give that a go. Okay. It still failed, but this time it was a completely different reason. So what's actually happening is a lot of my assets are expected to be served from a different port. So this is because if I go to Docker Compose, I'm using a Webpack dev server to hot reload my assets. And this pretty much doesn't work with service workers particularly well. So I have to remove that. And we're going to restart Rails again. Cool. So now when I request the page, Webpack's got to recompile everything. However, now it's done, we can see that we have a successful registration here. So if I was to quickly go to the debug page now and click inspect, you can see that console log we had in that service worker file is now in here, which is pretty nice. Now we've got that going, we're going to set up some recipes just to cache our documents and get things going. So I'm going to add these two libraries into Yarn. So I'm going to do yarn add webbox routing and the other one as well. Cool. I'm also going to add the next one as well. Awesome. So now I'm going to drop this into our service worker file. And I'm going to change this a little bit. Instead of matching the destination, I'm just going to write true for now. And I'm also going to change this to be a cache first kind of approach. So the first time we request that, it will get it from the network. After that, it will always serve it from the cache. And then after that point, if we turn off our web server, it'll just be available. Also, just going to quickly update this bit up here. So we pull the cache first strategy out of that. Okay, cool. Let's see what this does. Okay, we can see Webpack is compiling. Awesome. And if we do inspect element, you can see that's all registered. And if we go to here, we can see potentially what's been going on. You can see Workbox is saying, okay, yeah, I've got some cache stuff here. I can do that. So if I was to go into here, go back again, I could now turn this off. And if I was to reload the page, it will still work. We've previously seen this page, so that also still works. However, if I was to click edit, it would say, oh, there's something wrong, which is pretty fantastic. Okay, the one thing we need to be a bit careful of is we have the output from Webpack being generated to our public directory for that specific file. So we have to quickly go into our gitignore and make sure that like anything in slash public, which is .js or jet.map is not going to be in version control.